You are looking at the nightmare that happens every year across America. Pushing the limits of thin ice, a day ruined, property destroyed, and in the worst cases, lives lost. And it can happen on days like this, a seemingly normal day with just a little bit of a chill in the air. You want to be out there having fun on the lake, but it is essential that you know how thick the ice is, or a fun day can turn into a dangerous one. Ice thickness varies across the lake. Over there, it's right around 4 inches, which is the recommended minimum thickness for ice fishing. You can check for posted measurements, or better yet, measure for yourself, like I did earlier. It's around 10 inches near me. That's a solid amount of ice to help. Whoa! Oh, those snowmobiles can really pick up speed, and if you want to be snowmobiling like those guys, make sure there's a minimum of 5 inches of ice when you ride over a lake. And speaking of riding over a lake, check this out! Some ice can support vehicles, including a pickup truck, but it needs a full foot of ice to support that weight. If you do head out, make sure to drive slowly and stay at least 50 feet away from other vehicles. The weight of the truck alone can create waves that shift and crack nearby ice, making it extremely dangerous. Honestly, if you don't need to be out driving on the lake, don't do it. Oh no. Oh, did you hear that? Oh man, there goes the truck. Let's face it, even if you got one good measurement, that ice thickness can vary over short distances, and a frozen lake is never 100% safe, although that truck is 100% toast. Scenes like that one may actually become more common across America. Winters are warming, and the ice just doesn't last as long as it used to across many North American lakes. Climate models indicate this will continue. So take precautions seriously. Make sure to check ice thickness before you head out and enjoy that day on the lake, because times like these may not be like they used to be, and they may not last much longer.